Hello everyone, yes, I'm quite happy actually to present myself. I never expect actually it would be like so soon because I'm just starting, but it's true, my name is Charlotte Fourier and I'm the owner, proud owner of Brew Delicious. And I work together with Mahalie de Vink from Zitomania, and actually it's like almost a premiere, but tonight we are going to decide if we are going to buy or not to buy our own installation. And then actually it's because thanks to Valerie de Ketelare, she's the owner of Bazaar Trottoir, that we started during the period of Corona with our online brassen. So it's actually, we give information about beers, breweries on an online platform, and we do it like every 3 months. And together with Valerie, we have now a girl power box, and we are going to do this actually the 18th of October, and it would be like really wonderful if you would join us. So I'm just started, but I'm so happy because it's going like really well, and I never expected actually for having already an interview by Beer Idiots. So I'm really happy.
And what was your idea behind starting Brew Delicious?
Actually, it happens when I went to Bolivia. I think 6 years ago, so I went to Bolivia, and there I was like sitting on a terrace, and then some tourist, we were like starting to talk about beers, about Belgium, and then I find out actually that I have a beer passion because of my grandfather and my father. They learned me how to drink actually brown beers, and then I was like, hey, but I only drink Blue Chimay, Duvel and a Pintje. And we have such a huge, how do you say it actually, a huge amount of beers. And then the tourist actually in Bolivia, he was like, you don't know this one, and you don't know this one, and you're from Belgium. So I came back from Bolivia to Belgium, and I just wrote myself into this beer sommelier thing. And then it just went from another thing to another thing. And I thought with this beer sommelier thing, I would learn how to brew beer. Well, it's not true. You learn how to taste and how to smell beer, but not how to make your own beer. So after my beer sommelier, I had the skills to smell and taste, but I didn't have the skills to make my own beer. And then I moved to Anderlecht, and 2 days later I saw a commercial, do you want to make your own beer? Let's go to the coffee. And now I'm finished actually my study of being a brewer, thanks to Luc Pauwels, he's my master, and the coffee. So from one moment to another moment, I'm not only a sommelier, but I'm also a brewer, but still I really need to learn more and more, and it's unbelievable how big the beer world is actually.
And why girl power?
It's not because I'm a feminist, not at all actually, because I like to listen to different opinions, manly, female. Allez, it's not because of feminist, but I was a little bit surprised actually. You have a lot of men in the brewer world, and you have like a small amount of women in the brewer world, and I was quite surprised about that. And then I was like, especially Valerie, she has like this girl power walk in Brussels, and she was like, let's make a box about the female brewers in Belgium, and that's why we just want to give like a small platform to the female brewers in Belgium, and they are unbelievable, strong, independent beer lovers. Unbelievable, they have such a other taste, other view on beer actually than the men brewers, and I think now they're like with 16, I think, maybe more, but if you compare it with the manly, with the men brewers, it's a huge difference. Yeah, that's why.
And who's in the beer box? Can you name some of the Belgian brewers?
We have Vicaris from Dendermonde. It's like a father and his 4 daughters, and she's in the beer box. She has like this Vicaris triple from Dendermonde. It's a really nice one actually. It's full body triple. Then we went to Gruut Brewery in Ghent with Annick de Splinter, and she brews her beer without hop. So it's a completely different one than the Vicaris blend. And then we find a small little one in Marche-en-Famenne. So we have Dendermonde, Ghent, and then we have Marche-en-Famenne, and it's like brewery
atrium.
Yeah, unbelievable. Paula Yunus from Brasilia. I'm really impressed. Yeah.
Any others that people should check out? I mean, you're going to present them next week, I guess.
Yeah. Do you mean the female breweries? You have I think it's Terdolen of Terdolen in the Limburg, and it's from the same family as Annick de Splinter. And then you have, but it was difficult to reach her. We have Viven. It's a brewery in Damme, and Viven, they have a really nice IPA, and yeah, really check them out. Yeah.
I've tried them. And with your own brewery that you hope to get tonight, how exciting! What do you plan to do? Stay small, craft brewing. What kind of beers are your favorite? Do you hope to conquer the Belgium with and impress Belgium like the other female brewers that you know?
I think it's because I'm so surprised about the taste and about the flavors of beer, so I really want to learn more about the process of beer, or learn more about the ingredients. Maybe we're going to put a beer on the marketplace, but we need to figure it out, actually. Do we want to be like big? Because I'm really brown, I really love the brown beers. It would be like really amazing for having one good triple, one good brown one, and then one pintje. So actually, if we are going to introduce something on the beer world, then it's going to be three of these ones. But it's an idea. Maybe. I will not say definitely yes, we are going to conquer, so no.
And with Brewdelicious, you will hold tasting classes? What would you hold? What do you plan to do in terms of events or things?
For me, actually, it's really nice for having like this blind tasting degustation with other people, and to invite them actually to taste, to smell. And then they are saying van, oh my God, this is one, my favorite brand, but I really don't like it actually anymore because the other ones were so good and they were like more, I really want to take out people out of their comfort zone and that they learn a little bit more about the different beers. And because I was always stuck on my three brands, I knew I never go a little bit abroad, how do you say it, actually
wider
than my three things. And it's because when you met people who invite you to go a little bit more wider, you go to a cafe, you watch the menu, and then you say, hey, I never tried this one before. I'm going to order this one. Yeah. And then I'm going to try to remember the flavor of that beer. And that actually is my goal with the degustation, to ask people go a little bit more wider than always be in this. Yeah.
And I guess the competition's tough now. You have to go online to do this, to keep the business going, given the situation in Brussels and Belgium right now.
I think for me, because I do it beside my job, it's really nice and comfortable to do it. And we have sometimes we have like companies who are calling us to do like this online beer tasting, and that one goes really well. I hear from brewers they have really good time during Corona, and I also hear brewers who are saying when it's really difficult. But for me, this moment is quite okay. Yeah.
And what's your normal day job? I noticed these windows
My normal day job actually is, it's not easy to explain in English, not even in French or in Flemish. I'm like, working, it's not really for the government of Brussels, but I work a little bit for the government of Brussels, and my goal is actually to invent ideas, programs for people who doesn't have a job but also has like a really big distance to the to society. Yeah.
Was socially excluded.
Yeah. Yeah.
As so the commission usually says. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's actually social work, but it's like I need to help invent programs to help this kind of people back to our society. Yeah. So that's actually my regular job, but.
And your fun part is helping people widen their taste.
Like yeah, it's really, actually I'm helping on the both sides people. So yeah, it's really, actually I never expect to be, to already stand here actually. And it's really nice. Every time when I have a degustation, people are so happy. And I didn't expect it actually. I thought more people were like, she asking to do cheese with beer. Oh, I don't want it. But it's always after they're like, this is wonderful. Wow, thank you for this amazing evening. Thank you for open my eyes. Wow, I really want, yeah, now it's really difficult because we cannot go anymore to a cafe. That's for me a really hard part actually about Corona, because it's our culture to go to a cafe, meet friends, drink a beer, talk about it. But it's really nice to see how people are like after the degustation saying from, oh, I don't want to have this one anymore. I will go for another one. I will try this one. So yeah.
Widening people's taste, and I do love that aha moment.
Me also, yeah. And still, it's so nice. I thought I wouldn't be surprised anymore, but still now the world of beer has surprised me constantly. It's like a never-ending story. You take your bag, you just start to walk in the beer world, and it doesn't stop. So yeah, I think it's amazing.
Well, here's the never-ending story, and we hope your story goes on.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you so much. And if you're like more curious, just check the website of, so 18th of October we have like this girl power box. It's not a feministic box, it's like just beer who is brewed by women or girls, and we do it on the 18th of October. It's an online event with Bazaar Trottoir. You can find all the information on the Facebook page of Brew Delicious or the Facebook page of Bazaar Trottoir, or you can go directly to my beer box. You will see beer boxes, Bazaar Trottoir, Girl Power Box. I hope to see you then. Thank you.